A while back, we looked at the 10 greatest against all odds stories held by players currently in the NBA. But now we're going to look back at some all-time players and their against all odds stories that'll make you question how they ever really did make it into the NBA with every obstacle they faced on their journey. And for some of these guys, it's more than just a miracle that they got out of their bad situation, let alone into the NBA. But we're also throwing a couple current players in here too that I missed from the previous videos, so keep that in mind. This is part 1 with the first 5, and part 2 with the next 5 upcoming out soon, so subscribe and stay tuned for that. The first all-time player of this video, though, is Dennis Rodman. And Dennis Rodman may very well have the toughest against all odds story in NBA history. Because after seeing how he grew up and his situation, the fact that he was actually able to make it into the league just doesn't make any sense, and here's how it started. He was born in 1961 in Trenton, New Jersey, and at a young age, his father, Philander Rodman, abandoned his family. Now keep in mind that his father has said he's had 26 or 28 children with different women over the years, with Rodman contradicting that, saying that he was the oldest of 47 children that his dad had. Alright, let's pause for a minute. He may have had 47 children, which means that Dennis had 46 brothers and sisters. Or even if he had 26 or 28 like his dad said, that means he can't even keep track of how many he's had. Alright, unpause. But things were tough for Dennis. As a kid, he loved his mom, but she would have to work up to 4 jobs at a time to pay all the bills, so he really wouldn't get to see her that much. And on top of that, as a kid, Dennis said it was always clear that his mother was more interested in his two younger sisters, Deborah and Kim, who were always better basketball players than he was while growing up. His sisters even won 3 state titles in high school, while on the other hand, Rodman was 5'6" as a freshman, and he tried hard but never made a basketball or a football team, and actually graduated from high school at 5'9" tall, having never played an organized sport. So by the time he was 21 years old, he was working as a janitor when he hit a sudden random growth spurt and grew to be 6'7". I mean, that never happens. I don't even know how that's possible, but for Dennis it was. And with his new height, he decided to give basketball another try. So a family friend helped him get into an NAIA school, where he then averaged 25 points and 15 rebounds a game on 63% shooting in his 3 years there. And seeing how sudden of a growth spurt he had, it makes sense how he was able to play like he did. I mean, you gotta think, for him, he learned how to play basketball all of his life as a small player that had to play extra hard on defense and had to fight for the ball and rebounds every possession because he was undersized. So for him to have that same fire but now be the same height as everyone else is what made him as great as he was. But so with that said, he averaged the 25 and 15, then went on to a pre-draft camp and won MVP honors, which got him recognized by the Detroit Pistons, who then picked him up 27th overall in 1986. And from there, he would use his talents to become a 5-time NBA champion, a 2-time defensive player of the year, and a 7-time rebounding leader. The best rebounder the league has ever seen, and quite possibly the greatest overall defender. And he achieved all this after being 5'9" at 20 years old, and having never played organized basketball until he grew to be 6'7" at 21, in one of the most unlikely turnarounds of all time. Another one though belongs to Serge Ibaka, and for how wild his story is, I feel like it's not talked about enough or even just known in general. So here it is. He was born in the Republic of Congo in 1989, which is still a pretty bad place to this day, not even to mention 20 years ago. But growing up, Serge was the youngest of 18 children, which was a lot more common in Africa than it is in the United States. But he grew up with 10 of them. And surprisingly, both of Ibaka's parents played professional basketball for the national team of the Republic of Congo. So from 7 years old, they encouraged Serge to play basketball himself, and he played every single day growing up. He had a dream to play professionally somewhere outside of his country one day, but then things started to happen that would put that on hold. When he was 8, his mother passed away from natural causes, and before he turned 9, the Second Congo War started, which was the largest in African history. So Serge's family was forced to move away to a town that had no electricity or running water for 4 years. And when they finally returned home, Serge was 13. And they were just getting back into their normal lives when Ibaka's father was captured and jailed by the opposing country for over a year until the war ended. So all these things really took a toll on him, with all of it happening at such a young age. When it was finally over though, Serge set out to get his dream of playing basketball back on the right track. and his dad continued to teach him the game. And at 16, he joined his first team and played organized basketball for the first time. And he developed a ton there thanks to his father and his former teammates helping him out. So much so that he was invited to the 2006 Under-18 Africans Championship, where he was named MVP and attracted the attention of scouts from Spain. So he moved to France for a bit, played there, then learned Spanish and started playing semi-professionally in Spain, where he finally started getting interest in joining the NBA. So he also learned fluid English all before he turned 18. And that was when he entered a Reebok Eurocamp, where he got the attention of the Oklahoma City Thunder scout for his raw athleticism and his abilities. They then continued to watch him play for the next couple of months, before drafting him 24th overall in 2008. And it's crazy, some players just go to high school, train all their lives, go to college, then make it to the league. But others like Serge Ibaka had to take a much more difficult path. Another player I'm sure a lot of you didn't realize had such a hard time making it into the NBA is the NBA logo Jerry West. And okay, can we pause here? Since when is Jerry West the real name Jerome? That's just weird. But back to the story. So we all know Jerry West as being one of the greatest point guards of all time. And you'll see that he earned every bit of that through a lot of hard work and a little bit of luck. Because as a child, his dream was always to be a basketball player. The only thing though was that early on, Jerry was so short and small that he would have to go to the doctor all the time to get vitamin injections just so he could stay healthy. And because of this, a lot of the other kids would never let him play any sports with them. So instead, his neighbor put up his own hoop for him by his house. And Wes was out there every single day, whether it was hot, cold, raining, snowing, or whatever the conditions were. As long as the sun was out, he was shooting every single day, mastering shots from every spot on the court. And it led to him being able to make his middle school basketball team, even though for his first two entire years, he was mainly stuck on the bench. But by his freshman year in high school, even though he was only still 5'6", he not only made the team, but made it as the team captain. And that was through working harder than everyone else and learning from every game that he was stuck on the bench. But then in 1953, in his sophomore season, he suddenly grew 6 inches up to 6 feet tall, to where he would start playing small forward and establishing himself as one of the best players in the country. And it led to over 60 universities showing interest in him. And he ended up picking West Virginia University and growing up to 6'3". And there he became even more of a star, and by his senior year was averaging 29-16-4. So he was easily selected second overall by the Lakers in the 1960 NBA draft. And from there, as we know, became an NBA legend. But another hard worker with a great story is a name we really don't hear from too much anymore in Amari Stoudemire. He grew up in Central Florida, and like most other NBA players, grew up playing basketball and football from an early age. And early on, he had an okay life. His parents did divorce when he was young, and neither of them were wealthy by any means, but they weren't struggling. That was until Amari's father passed away when he was 12 from a heart attack. It then meant that he had to live with his mother full time. And she couldn't keep up with the bills any longer, so she was always in and out of prison for various crimes like stealing, and that meant he had no parents. Just like that, his life had completely took a turn for the worse, but he had some instrumental people in his life that helped him through it, like a cop named Bernie Hayes, who gave Amari and his brother somewhere to sleep every night, and convinced Stoudemire to stop playing football and focus solely on basketball. And it was from that day on that he decided he was gonna become an NBA player one day. He needed it because he needed to get his family out of their bad situation, and he used his dad's passing to motivate him, including his last words, which were, "The sky's the limit, Amari." So by the time he was 14, he was 6'6" with a natural instinct for the game like no other, and it was time he took his talents to a real high school team. Because up until that point, he had never played organized basketball. It was tough though, because moving in and out of houses due to his mom meant that he transferred between 5 high schools in 2 states 6 different times, which caused him to only be able to play 2 years of high school basketball. But he was so naturally talented that that was all he needed, because by his senior year he was averaging 29-15-6 and was ranked as a 5-star recruit and the number 1 overall player in the country in 2002. And with all the scholarships he got, he was originally committed to the University of Memphis, but later decommitted, joined the NBA draft, and was taken 9th overall by the Phoenix Suns in 2002. And it's crazy because his story shows that when players are playing high school and college basketball, they're not always just fighting to become a great player. A lot of times, they're fighting to get their families out of their situations and give them all a better life. And that's what DJ Banga was doing too. Now, you might not be too familiar with him because he wasn't popular or a good player, but if you do remember him, you'll remember that he played for the Lakers during their 2 championships in 2009 and 10. The man only averaged 1.8 points a game for his career, but his story is so great it was worth mentioning anyways. So like Serge Ibaka, DJ was was also born in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, where his father worked for the government up until DJ was 17 years old. But then when the new government took over, they looked to take down everyone who worked for the previous leaders. So they kidnapped Banga and his family for 2 years, and DJ's father would later bribe a security guard to let his wife and son go free while he stayed behind. And he did, but was never seen again. So DJ and his mom fled to another country. And before we get any further, let's not forget to mention here that by this point, Banga was 7 feet tall. But in that new country, he not only played basketball for the first time, but at 19 years old in 1999, it was the first time he had ever seen a basketball at all. Then soon after was discovered by a man named Willie Steveners, who mentored him and led to him playing for a few professional Belgian basketball clubs. 5 years after picking up a basketball for the first time, he signed with the Dallas Mavericks in 2004, and would go on to play in the league for the next 7 years off the bench. So this man escaped being locked up in another country, didn't start basketball until 19, and made the NBA after only 5 years of playing. Again, he didn't have a great career, but the fact that he made it as far as he did in such little time is what makes this such a great story. And that's gonna wrap up part one. I had to break it into two parts so I could fully tell all of these athlete stories. So subscribe if you're not already. Stay tuned for part 2 coming soon. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I'll catch you next video.